I'm Nico.
I'm Lucky. And we are showing the movie Crossing Lebanon, because we crossed Lebanon on skis to ski the best slopes Lebanon has to offer.
So it's a ski touring movie,
yeah,
kind of.
Yeah, exactly. I started skiing when I was 3 years old. Then I started ski racing at the age of 6. And at the age of 13, I started skiing in the park, learned some tricks, backflips and stuff. And I also started free riding, which is now my biggest passion.
Yeah, so for me, it's pretty much the same. Like, also started skiing when I was 3, but I never ski raced, and then just slowly turned towards free riding, I guess. Lugi filmed me and I filmed Lugi.
In fact, we are both the athletes and he is more the filming brain.
But I'm not sure if I would be just the filmmaker if I wouldn't be able to do the activity myself.
But you're pretty passionate about filming.
Yes, I am passionate. I am passionate about filming.
I also have to film. Yeah. I'm not that experienced, but I have a good teacher.
At the time when we were there, it did help us a lot because it offered like so many good runs.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, many runs we couldn't do because we just had to walk. But I guess it offers a lot for skiing and for ski touring. So.
And the weather and the conditions turned out pretty good. And we still found some pretty nice powder on north faces.
I guess Lebanese nature is something to come back to. Well, it's probably one of the reasons why I love the country so much. I mean, I've been there 3 times now, and I will come back to Lebanon many more times, and it's for the people and everything, the food, but also for the nature, I guess.
For me, I was there only one time, and crossing the Lebanese mountains was pretty sure the hardest thing I've done so far, and we've lived in the nature for 10 days straight without contact to any other people, and it was such an intense experience which I will never forget, and so I'm pretty bounded to the Lebanese nature. Mountains for sure.
Same here, mountains. If it's a good winter, always winter.
Mm-hmm. You can get warm in the cold, and in the hot you can't dress naked.
Which he does like to do.
Yep.
Just with the brain I can kind of detach, and if it's for a long time I can just kind of cut it off. Strength, I'm just not very strong for that matter.
I guess this is pretty much the exact same thing for me. For me, I think it's better to do an individual sport, but always with some friends and having fun, which is super important in individual sports.
Well, for me, like, I really love both of them. If I had to choose, I probably would go for team sports.
Well, I think I like the risk, but always with some...
Puffer.
Ja, genau. Fuck.
Ein Sicherheitspuffer.
Ja, ein Sicherheitspuffer. Das
I think I'm more the safety first guy. Like, I do go risky from time to time because safety is subjective, I guess.
Well,
speed.
Yeah,
speed.
I like speed.
Just have fun. Also look for friends who can push you.
Finding a peer group is definitely the most important thing when you are young and trying to do a new sport. If you're a young guy and you have a cool crew, make a movie. When I was 16, there was one crew in the Allgäu where I grew up, which made really, really good movies. And one of them ended up in the national team for skiing, and the other one ended up as a professional filmmaker who is doing Red Bull movies now, like the Snowmads movie, if you have heard of it. just before the lockdown, I bought this beautiful VW bus, and this was my project during the lockdown, building it and making it nice to sleep in. And yeah, well, here is my bed, my wardrobe, and all other nice stuff with what you need to go to the mountains, sleep there, and explore crazy stuff.
Well, I was skiing with friends in a hut, so we were like 20 people in one hut. And because we just, I don't know, no one really cared that much, but then suddenly confinement happened, and it was like 1 week later and it was confinement, so.
We went to the hills, had no service on our mobile phones, had a great time there, and we carried an oven, and wood oven, 3 tents, 10 liters of wine, a lot of vegetables and nice food. We had the best time you can imagine up there, skied a lot of nice slopes. And on the 15th of March, we came back to civilization, and it was crazy. Like, all borders were closed in Europe. We had struggled coming back to Germany, and everyone was freaking out about Corona. And then the next day, lockdown happened.
So the first thing I did was doing a hang glider course. No, not a hang glider, paraglider course.
And for me, I just finished building up this bus. And then we did a bike road trip with a few kids. We went to some bike parks and shredded those bike parks, which was pretty fun. Yeah, the thing I would recommend is Ice and Palms. I think you can find it in English. These are two German guys who I know, and they did a crazy Transalp tour, cycling up with their bikes and ski touring up to the biggest and most epic mountains in the Alps.
I would recommend another German documentary. It's called Weit, which actually means wide in German. And it's just like a couple who goes around the world without air travel. So they just hitchhike, and because there are many people who did similar things, but in that documentary it's really not about them, but it's like about the people they meet.
I also did my paragliding license, and the next step would be base jumping, I guess. And maybe the next step wingsuiting.
One other thing is probably like I do kitesurf a little bit, but I want to try foil kiting at some point. I think it's really cool because you kind of just fly in the air. But
for the sport part, our Trans-Lebanese trip was pretty hard. I think that's the hardest sport activity I've done so far.
Yeah, it was cold, it was hot, it was like tiring mentally and physically. And if I think about it now, it's like, oh yeah, it's really fun. But then if I like really try to remember, it's like, yeah, there were some hard hours.
But like on the day we came back, we both said, well, that was cool, but not soon again.
I don't know, I usually just like scream like yeehaw, yeah, or something like that.
Yeah, that's something like that.
That's much more accurate.
Yeah. I think you can hear it in our movie.
But have
hope
fun.
You enjoy the movie.
Hopefully we see you at the film festival.
Yeah.
We'd love to be there.